and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Kindle in us the fire of thy love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today is the Thursday of Pentecost week, the day intervening between our two summer Ember days. We resume the chants of the Mass of Pentecost itself, whilst we have a proper epistle and a gospel. Our saints today, children, continue to be, and this would not surprise us, Holy Ghost fire saints. First of all, let me mention that the Holy Ghost inspires, just as yesterday, a saint who was a great apologist or a defender of the Catholic faith, but always with a view towards making conversions. His name was St. Optatus. And St. Optatus was bishop in northern Africa during the Donatist heresy. Now, the Donatists held that if you were sinful, meaning a priest, you couldn't say a valid mass or give absolution or anything like that, and that they alone were non-sinful, and that their little tiny sect in Africa and in Rome was the only true Catholic Church. And they went so far, the Donatists did, in their diabolically driven fury against Catholics, to destroy Catholic altars, because they would say it wasn't a valid mass anyway, and to burn the altar itself and to burn the altar linen. St. Optatus, who usually, as I say, wrote in a very sort of a calm, quiet way with a view towards converting them back, once or twice, gave them a good piece of his mind about that. And he said, well, if you're destroying the altar, why don't you destroy the earth that's under the altar? And once you're digging, he said, and then he got a little carried away, even saints get carried away, he said, once you're digging, you could dig right down to hell, and you'll find the founders of your sect. But every now and again, it was good for the saint to remind them of what a wicked thing it was for them to be so schismatic and so heretical. Now, today we have as well the feast day of a saint, and he's our main saint commemorated at our Pentecost Mass, St. Francis Caracciolo, who was a wonderful, a holy saint, but like, remember St. John, big sinner yesterday? He used to sign himself to St. Francis, the sinner. The saints are always very humble. First of all, we go in spirit to the Church of St. Lawrence without the walls, outside of the walls of Rome. And St. Lawrence is a saint, remember, who was more on fire with the Holy Ghost in his own heart, and so much so that he didn't really feel the flames of the barbecue as he was being slowly roasted to death for our holy faith. It was the same fire that distinguished today's main saint, Francis Caracciolo. He was called the preacher of the love of God. And he had a wonderful gift when he preached to put people on fire with God's love. He also illustrates in his life, children, how God never makes any mistakes and how everything is part of the divine providence. And we must always try by prayer, we talked about this yesterday, to figure out, now what is our Lord up to for us? And to say yes to our Lord. So, for example, he was a young nobleman in 16th century Naples, that general area, and he was fairly devout and a pretty good young man, but he spent a lot of time hunting, just sort of riding around and hunting because that's what they did back then, and didn't have to work for a living or anything. Well, he got a horrible kind of a skin disease that was a bit like leprosy, and it was so serious that he almost died of it. So he made God a promise. He said, dear Lord, if I get better, I'll dedicate my life to serving you and to serving my neighbor. Well, almost immediately, he got better. And unlike some, he kept his vow and promise, and he became a priest. Now, back then in Naples, there were a zillion priests. There were so many priests, they didn't know what to do with them all. So, once again, he could have, as other priests did, not do too much with his time. But he was finished with that now. He was on fire with the love of God. So he joined a confraternity called Bianchi della Giustizia, meaning the white robes of justice. And the members of this confraternity wore white, and they would attend their official meetings. And then they would attend to criminals, to those who were suffering, the justice of the state or the church, and especially they would help those who were going to die to make a good death. And so he was just a good work to do. There's not that many did it, or did it well. And then a mistake happened. And due to this mistake, the mailman made a mistake. But due to this, he found his life's work. You see, there was a priest in Genoa, which is in northern Italy, not too far from France, named Giovanni Adorno. And this Father Adorno was a very devout man. And he wanted to found an order of priests that would live together a little bit like the Franciscans. And they would be called the minor clerk regular. Well, he wrote to a priest who he knew in Naples, who had the same name as our saint. And it was Ascanio Fracciolo. And the mailman got the two priests mixed up, which would be easy enough to do, because you wouldn't think with a funny name like Ascanio Fracciolo that there would be two of them. Well, he got, St. Francis got the letter instead of his distant cousin. But when he read the letter from this devout priest in Genoa, he thought, that's the ticket, that's the very thing. I want to join this order. And so he did. And later on, he was actually one of the founders, and later on he was the father superior of this order and helped it to spread very much throughout the church. Now what they did in their order was this, children, that they wanted to pray all the time, and that the old days it was understood if you prayed at regular hours, then you prayed all the time. So they took turns. The genius of the order was this. Everybody took turns. So what one person was doing represented everyone else. So he began perpetual adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. So everyone would take turns. They would take 1 hour during the day or the night each day, each 24-hour period, to make adoration, as we'll be doing a week from today when, by God's grace, we'll be keeping the great feast of Corpus Christi. And what else did they do? Well, they took turns doing penance. The idea was we should all be doing lots of penance for sinners, so let's take turns, so that way we won't get bored doing penance. So one priest would fast on bread and water, and somebody else would take the discipline, which means that you kind of scourge yourself on your back, and another priest would do say quite a few long prayers on his knees, and so forth. All of the classic ways of doing penance, they would divide them up. And what one did, that represented everybody else, just as one represented everybody else at the altar. And then last of all, the final thing that they did was they took turns around the house, too. Just as you children probably do, if you come from a well-organized family. That is to say, 1 week it's your turn to sweep the floor, 1 week it might be your turn to clean the bathroom, or to set the table, or do the dishes, things like that. They took turns for those things, too. They were very humble. And in the meantime, when they weren't cleaning the bathroom or praying before the Blessed Sacrament, they would go out and preach, and our saint especially heard lots of confessions and made many, many converts. And think of it. All of that happened because of a mistake. He got the wrong letter in the mail. But God the Holy Ghost was directing the whole thing for the glory of God and for the conversion of souls. When the time came for our saint to die, and he died 401 years ago, I think, when the time came for our saint to die, he was surrounded by priests, of course, and they were all saying prayers. He was a very young man, he was only 45. And all of a sudden, he sits up in bed, and he says, "Allora, andiamo," which is Italian for, "Okay, let's go." And the other priests looked at each other, and they thought to themselves, "Where is he going? He's dying. He's not going anywhere." So they said to him, "Father, what do you mean, let's go?" And he said, "Let's go to heaven." And he closed his eyes, fell back on the pillow, and that's exactly what he did. He went to heaven, which is our only job here below, isn't it? Let us ask the Holy Ghost to inspire us today, children, so to live, and even to make use of the seeming mistakes of others, so that we too can be going to heaven and saving our immortal souls. Today's First Thursday, let's say a special prayer for all priests to be on fire, consumed with God's love, the Holy Ghost. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.